is able to get back. And now Jordan guarding Barkley. Grant over to help. Hawkins had the lane closed by Pippen. Good defensive sequence by the Bulls.
Well, the Bulls are so athletic, they can switch at times on the floor, still not wind up with a real bad matchup.
Jordan with the reject. And at a 4 second clock showing 24, but it has been changed to a 22.
Because the ball hits the rim, there should be a reset. They have the clock at 2 seconds.
Horn and Hawkins. Pippen again on a deceptive dribble. It's a 3-on-2. Barkley with the spin. Hawkins, and he'll go to the line. Nice pass from Barkley. Turner could not connect on the reverse. Sixers get the new 24. Barkley again facing the double team and kicks it out. Anderson goes to the left hand, and that is offensive interference. With a second, not Pippen. Barkley able to get to it. It is only a 12-point Chicago lead. We appear to be on the way to a blowout, and Charles Barkley single-handedly has brought the Sixers back. He called on the horn.
Two pretty good players going one-on-one. Right now, Michael Jordan saying, okay, I know somebody's coming to help me on this, but you know what? Nobody was there.
Indianapolis. Again, it's Barkley on the rebound. Here's Barkley. Changed his mind. Hawkins for three.
A big team. They're a small front line when you talk about height. And then they're not a real good rebounding team, ranking in the bottom four or five teams in team rebounds this season versus a team in Chicago who's strong in the rest.
The pressing defense of the Bulls. They have not been able to handle it. Phil Jackson will only use it in spots. He'll flash it at him, and it's been.
And he's doing a great job creating opportunities for his teammates now.
Ron Anderson on the drive, off the glass, rebound. Barkley can't hold it. Chicago ball. The Bulls up to a 6-point.
Into the middle and seal him off. When he gets baseline, he just jumps over you, finds cutters going to the basket. He gets himself an uncompromising situation because of his great leaping ability and find the open man.
They got Barkley posted inside against Michael Jordan, the double team. They reverse it to Hersey Hawkins. Gillian was late getting him the ball. He buries the three anyway.
Michael Jordan playing Charles Barkley on a switch. Michael Jordan working hard to try to get in front of Barkley. Barkley's just so big and strong. Here comes the double team. Horace Grant that leads Armand Gilliam open at the top. They find Gilliam. One extra pass. Hersey.
Game for the Sixers. Looking for Barkley. Knocked out of bounds by Chicago. 12 seconds on the clock.
Gilliam just allowed him to come in. He never put a body on him.
6-point lead now for Chicago.
Pippen doing a good job on Barkley.
Barkley had the ball batted away as he got into the paint.
6 seconds.
Jordan. Most unusual pass attempt that went astray. Oh, look at that. Barkley getting away with a palm.
No, a high dribble.
Yes. Right. Jordan questioned it. And off the double team, the kick ball is called.
Barkley loves to lead fast breaks, one of the small forwards in the league that has the ability to do that. And right about here, he loses control. The official said, no, no, it just went straight up and down, a high dribble. Jordan said, oh, no, he turned it over.
Brown wanted a charge. Down to 10 seconds to go in the half. Barkley trying to clear it out as he goes against Jordan. And then pitches it back. Green for three. Now that is the end.
Uncontested, wide open 17-footers that they're going to knock down if you keep letting them stand around and shoot it. Must put more pressure on.
The backdoor lob did not work. Here comes Barkley. And once again, he tried to get too cute and turned it over.
Well, it's a plus and it's a minus when you have the player of Charles' ability to rebound and lead the fast break and make so many things happen. Yet at times, when he's not totally comfortable with what he's trying to do there, you'd rather have your guards making those decisions at the end. They've done that.
Arrogance or confidence or combination thereof. Well, Michael Jordan and Charles Barkley happen to be very close off the court, enjoying the moment. Although I think Michael is enjoying it a little bit more.
Barkley, no whistle at all. Gilliam gets the defensive board. Barkley hard to the hoop. Missed the lay-in. Pippen rebound. And Pippen is fouled. Charles says, how'd I do that? Reed's first of all. Barkley gets the board. Erksy Hawkins returns it to Barkley. He gets the lay-in. And now it is a three-point Bulls lead. And Charles Barkley has 28 points. Timeout Chicago. And Doug, you and I have another close ball game.
All you have to do is have us here. Foul there or something. You just can't let Michael. He's got 10 of the 17 points in this quarter. You've got to prevent him from getting a layup in that situation.
Michael has the last 10 Chicago points. Barkley to Green for the open jumper. No rebound. Jordan, 17. That's a playoff career high. 17 seconds to go. Bulls by three. Game is over. The Sixers are eliminated. The Bulls advance to the Eastern Conference Championship Series, 100-95.